Okay, so here's another way to save those multiple calls to OMP get thread num. So this is something called thread private variables. So what you can do is you can make variables persistent across parallel sections. Okay, so here's how you do it. So this is a variable TID, and you declare over here that this is a thread private variable. Okay, and this is the way to do it. You say hash pragma omp thread private and then the variable name. What it's telling the compiler is that I want this variable to be retained across parallel sections. So it's going to allocate this not on the stack, right? Because I mean the stack may come and go whenever the threads are launched, whenever forks and joins happen. It's going to allocate space for this variable in some thread private region, right? Some region which is there for every thread. Maybe the stack is also stored over here. So maybe it might decide to store the stack and some variables, whatever are the thread private variables in this space, right? So every thread will have some space, some thread local space, and it's going to allocate space for this variable over there. Okay. The important point is that this variable does not lose its value across parallel regions. Now what happens in this code is that at this point of time I call TID equal to omp get thread num. But now in the second parallel region I don't need to make a call to TID equal to omp get thread num again, because TID is declared to be thread private and I have already initialized it over here. So this value is going to stay with that thread for its lifetime. What does that mean? There's this master thread that's executing. When it encounters this parallel region, it launches 4 threads. When this region ends, it comes together, again a single thread executes, again 3 threads are launched, there are total 4 threads, and again they join back. Right? This is the life cycle of the threads. But here's the important part: if this is thread 0, this is thread 1, 2, and thread 3, and this is thread 0, 1, 2, and 3, the value of the variable of the thread private variable over here is the same as the value of the thread private variable over here. Thread 0 will see the same thread private variable. So it's by the thread ID. The same thread having the same ID will see the same value. Okay? So that saves me the trouble of making another call to omp get thread num. I've stored it in a thread private variable, and thread private variables exist across multiple parallel regions. Okay? So this is important because when I set up threads, right, a lot of time I start maintaining some state in every thread, that what is the work it is supposed to do and so on. And then, you know, I'm done with this particular parallel region and later on I want to again start a parallel region, but I know what is the work I was supposed to do. What was the work I was supposed to do? I'm not going to start, you know, figuring that out again. That's stored in some thread private variable. I'll just pick it up and continue my work. Okay? Any questions so far? So the point is that you don't use thread private variables for sharing purposes. You use it for private purposes, right? Eventually, when you want to accumulate the work across threads, you would use a shared variable for that. Not a thread private variable. Not a private variable, not a thread private variable, but a shared variable. Okay? So this is the output that I get. And here is the important part, right? Thread private only applies to file scope or static variables. So if you've defined a variable which is on the stack, if it's local inside a function, then you cannot declare it to be thread private. So here's an example. This is something I tried to do. Int numpty is defined inside main and I declare it to be thread private. So when I try to compile it, the compiler will give me an error. Okay? There's one important thing to point out, that is that if you access a thread private variable from outside the parallel region, what is the value you're going to get? What value should I see in a thread private variable if I access it outside the parallel region, not inside the parallel region? Inside the parallel region, each thread will get to see the value that it had set, right? But what about outside the parallel region?
The main thread.
What is the main thread? thread 0. Thread 0 is the same as the main thread. So whatever you are doing inside thread 0, that same variable is visible outside the parallel region. Okay, so this is going back to the same program where PID is declared to be thread private, right? And then this was the code which executed fine. So here what we are trying to do again is something which doesn't make a lot of sense. We are actually using the hash pragma OMP parallel region as a point of synchronization between all the threads, right? To ensure that no thread proceeds ahead beyond this point. So this is something called a barrier operation. Right, what is a barrier? A barrier is a point where all the threads must come together before any of them proceeds further. So all the threads must hit the barrier before proceeding further. So we are actually using this as a barrier, right? That's what I'm doing. I did not want any thread to print hello world until thread 0 had initialized numpty. So what did I do? I defined this parallel region, hash pragma OMP parallel, and what is the purpose it's serving? The only purpose it's serving is that no thread can go beyond this point. That's the purpose it's serving, right? So there's a simpler way to do that in OpenMP. There is this construct called hash pragma OMP barrier, right? So if I introduce that over here, then it will wait for all the threads to come together at this point in time before any thread proceeds further, okay? So that does the same work that I was trying to do earlier. It serves the same purpose, but now I don't need thread private variables. I mean, I was using all these thread private variables and everything because I had two separate parallel regions. Now I have a single region. I don't even need to bother about thread private variables. Right? So I can write a simple piece of code and just put a hash pragma OMP barrier. So all the other threads will come and wait over here because thread 0 hasn't come. When thread 0 reaches over here, then all of them will proceed ahead. Right? And we know by that time thread 0 would have already called OMP get num thread. So this variable would have been initialized. And I run this program and I see what I expected. Okay, now instead of using a barrier, there is another construct that OpenMP provides. So what is so special about thread ID 0, right? Why did I want thread ID 0 to initialize the variable? There was nothing particular about it. I just had to pick one thread, and the only way I need to pick a thread is if I say thread ID 0, right? So if you want some work to be only done by one thread, there's a better way of doing it, and that is hash pragma OMP single. Only one thread executes the code inside this construct. And it provides a synchronization at the end of the construct. Right, so at the end of hash pragma OMP single, it provides an implicit barrier. So no thread can proceed ahead until all the threads have reached this point. Right, but obviously the code inside hash pragma OMP single is only executed by one thread. And it doesn't have to be thread 0, it can be any thread. Okay, that's the important part. Whichever thread comes here first will start executing it. In a parallel program, that's what I want, right? If I have some region which is to be executed by one thread, why do I want thread 0 to do it? Whoever gets free earlier can come and do it. Okay, so this code also works fine, right? Does what I want to do. Now, there's a option called no wait. So if you want one thread to do some work and there's no race condition and you do not care if the other threads go ahead or not, then you can write hash pragma OMP single no wait. Right? With this no wait option, what happens is that one of the threads will execute this code in this construct and all the other threads will proceed ahead without waiting for this thread. And I execute this code and this is what I see again, right? Okay, there is one other construct. This is called hash pragma OMP master. It's similar to hash pragma OMP single, except that it's always the master thread that executes this part of the code. Right? So it's always going to be thread 0, the master thread. So it's like explicitly saying if TID equal to 0. So why would I want a particular thread to always execute some code? So there are lots of times that I am maintaining some state, right? Like for instance, one of the threads is the master thread, which is distributing work to the other threads. Let's say that it's keeping track of how much work has already been done, how much is left. Maybe there's one thread which is keeping track of all that. That's generally the thread we call the master thread, right? So what will happen is that within this construct, right, within this region, the variables that you access are going to be the variables of thread 0 of the master thread. Okay, you're not guaranteed that in hash pragma OMP single. In hash pragma OMP single, the threads that you see may be different every time you call hash pragma OMP single. Right? They'll be of the thread which is executing that region. But in case of hash pragma OMP master, so if I am calling hash pragma OMP master thrice, I will always see the same locations, the same memory locations, the same variables. So when I say that you're going to see the same variable, I'm talking about thread private variables. Right? So if you have thread private variables, you're going to see the same thread private variable, which is of thread 0 every time you write a hash pragma OMP master construct, you use that construct and you write code inside that. Okay?